Because the life of every creature is its blood. That is why I have said to the Israelites, you must not eat the blood of any creature, because the life of every creature is its blood. Anyone who eats it must be cut off. Amen.
Amen.
Father, in the right name of Jesus, as we are starting with the glory, from the empty way of life handed down from your They trampled over him. This, I don't want this vision in this one. Can we get somebody in the vision has to say they conquered? Yes, it's fine. We're going to overcame this.
And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death.
Amen.
Amen.
This one says, and they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they loved not their lives even unto death.
Amen.
Amen.
What was God teaching us before we Christ? The same God who doesn't change. You know, those who came before us, they said there is power in them.
Blood.
There is victory in the name of
Jesus.
There is, they said all those things. What is it that about the blood that the Leviticus is saying that life is in the blood? What was the message of the cross? I know it's not Easter, but this message, we need to hear it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
When God was saying, apply it, it was meaning, when I pass by, no destruction, no plague will come near you, because the life of every creature is in the blood. When they see the blood, it means there is no longer life. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
When you die and arise with him, in the book of Romans 3:14 and Colossians, it says those things. What is it that we need to die and rise with him? The issue of the blood.
Amen.
Because when we die and arise with him, it means it's no longer me who lives. God is saying that, but it's Christ in me who lives. Redeemed through the blood, because when the devil comes and recognizes the blood in his mind, because he knows that the principle is saying the life of every creature is in the blood, he gets confused and says, the blood job has been done here. Even if he has a trust job.
Amen.
Amen. You need to confuse him. Remember, the book that the Bible is saying, he is an old one. In the book of Revelation, he beats us with age, the devil. He beats us because he understands the scriptures.
Yes.
And he still understands that the life of every creature is in the blood. Mm-hmm. He knows that how God operates. That's when we are hiding behind the blood of Jesus, then he says, like they did in Egypt.
Amen.
If you read with her today, the same night, Pharaoh did not wait for the morning. The same night he called Moses and Aaron and said, hey, take your people and go. Because the Bible says, even the first child of Pharaoh died that night. He did not choose whether he's the son of a king or what. But as long as there was no blood of the lamb, the blood of the lamb, and the book of Revelation says they conquered with the blood of the lamb.
Amen.
We conquer only through this blood because we apply the blood like they did.
Amen.
If it's a sickness, it's a challenge, everything, what you need to do, we apply the blood. We just need to apply the blood. And when he comes, the accuser of brothers. Because when before this verse that they conquered, in the book of Revelation, the Bible is explaining him as an accuser. This accuser, when he comes and fights you, having this blood that never loses power. The blood said it never loses power. Why did the blood of Cain and Abel? Why was the blood crying? What is it about the blood? My message for you is not wrong today. It's to tell you that there is power in you.
Amen.
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 There is healing.
Amen.
In the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
There is breakthrough. There is deliverance. There is everything that you may think of. If you think your life is done, go home and apply the blood of Jesus.
Yes. Amen.
When the accuser comes,
yes,
and he sees the blood that never loses power,
amen.
Because he's still in the Leviticus thinking that the life of every creature is in the blood, he laughs and says, I am done.
Amen.
When Jesus has died for you,
amen.
When the blood was shed for you,
amen.
It's no longer I who lives, it's Him who lives, because we die with Him and we rise with Him. Hence, He cannot touch us.
Amen.
The issue is in the blood.
Amen.
It is in the blood. You know, when you look at God, He is saying to us, I don't change anything the same. So why can't we apply the blood as it is to the children of Israelites? If you can check there what was happening with Pharaoh and Moses, there are a lot of things that happened at that time. God was just putting a stamp to say, hey, Pharaoh, let my people go. He was putting a stamp to say, tonight is the night.
Yeah.
If you do not let them go, imagine what could have happened. Pharaoh saw that even his son died, but none of the Israelites' children died. You know, the book of Exodus, there's a verse that says, when God was talking to Moses, he said, no dog will be back in your compound. There will be destruction all over. But in your yard, in your compound, no dog will bark. This simply means there are a lot of things that will happen around you.
Jesus.
But the dog in your own yard will not bark. What does that mean? Have you ever seen a dog when he hears things happening around you? The promises of God upon our lives. Stamp it.
Amen.
And see what's going to happen. Because the accuser will come and say, I'm finished here tonight. But when he comes and see the blood, the blood in that door, don't bring on the slammer's house. Who would think that I'm done with no man? Can't you know that he's a resurrecting of Christ?
Amen.
That's how it works with our God. Why the, you know, he is saying the same power that rose Jesus from the dead is the same power that lives in us. Why is he saying all those things? Do you think that when we use, let's come and just think about it. Do you think it's possible? Unless we pray as a blood.
Yeah.
That would brought us back to Him.
These
people, they did not die, and God was putting a stamp because He was saying to them, I'm taking you to the promised land. He gave an example to the blood of the Lamb so that His people can be led free. So when that happened, they went out. When we accept Jesus in our lives, the blood that has been shed for us, we are set free. Hence the Bible says, when Jesus set us free, we are free indeed. God, you are actually teaching us and showing us how these things work through the children of Israelites in Egypt. The sufferings that we are having, the sufferings that we heard, they suffered many years as slaveries there. They suffered and suffered, they prayed and prayed. And God, when he's speaking to Moses, he's saying, he is not saying, I am hearing. I want us to understand something about God. God uses the same principles all the time. When he's speaking to Moses, he's saying, I have heard. Jesus is saying, I am praying for you. It means when I start applying the blood, God can say, I have heard.
Amen.
I have heard my son, the Lamb, interceding for this one, interceding for this one, interceding for this one. There is no way we will not go to the promise.
Amen.
Anything that is stubborn, refusing to let us go, but through the blood, trust you me, there is nothing that can stop us.
Amen.
The blood that speaks better things. What is the Bible saying? Which better thing is this blood talking about? You have tried a lot of things. Try the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Why is it? I just want to give a simple example. Why is it when these people that are not born again, when they do things for their ancestors, why is it that the blood is needed? The devil knows. The devil knows that when this blood, when these things are happening, what does it mean? Hence, God ahead. Is he not the firstborn? Hmm. Why is it that they are slaughtering goats, they are slaughtering chickens, and they will tell you that after I slaughtered my things are going okay? Why is it? Because the principles of God don't change. He operates the same. He knew that for my people to go, something about the blood has to happen. For us to be reunited with him, something about the blood has to happen. And he could not redo it and redo it and redo it and redo it. Hence he sent Jesus. Because when he's talking to Moses here, tell them to remember this every time when they are children. So he could not just say every time, like now, how many of us have lambs? How many of us have goats, chicken? So it means we were not going to be set free because, like, we hence he had to do it with Jesus because we are going to be in trouble.
Amen.
We were in. We were not going to get anything. We were not going to be delivered from anything. Because some of us don't really have a mere chicken to slaughter. If now I say, bring your chicken, no, why are you going to get it? But because he knew,
amen,
he knew that times like this will come.
Amen.
Times like this where there's corona.
Amen.
It's not that you don't die because of corona. He allows corona to come in. When he comes to finish you out, he sees the blood and says, I've done my job.
Amen.
The mentality of the enemy.
Amen.
The accuser of liars.
Amen.
We got him here. Like when we got it in the book of Job, he's saying to God, the only thing that I cannot access Job is because you have built a hedge of protection around him.
Yes.
So we know that the only way he cannot get to us is through the hedge. We know the only way he cannot get to us is when he thinks, when he sees the blood, he is done with us.
Amen.
We need to understand him because he beat us with age and understanding these things. Trust me, he was in heaven. Me and you have never been there.
Mm.
He knows. And if you even feel a boy,